So I've gotten a request to do a tutor video on how to write your CV. So I know that this is actually a planned class nearer to the end of the year, but I do understand that you guys want to give out your CVs now already, so it will be a good idea to know more or less how to put it together. And then in that class, maybe you can just better your CV for the next year. Okay guys, so I've chosen this little picture that says, "Make my CV sound awesome." Okay, so I can't do this, but you can do it by following the following steps. Okay. Let's first start with how to write your CVs. Now I'm going to give you tips and ideas, and you can take them or discard them just like you feel. Remember, a CV is something that is personal. You don't have to have all the information. You don't even have to have any of the information that I give you. This is just to guide you if you want to have a proper CV. Okay, so the first point says, don't use a generic CV. Now what does this mean? Don't take a CV template off of the internet, fill your own details in, and send it to 20 schools and hope that one of them will come back and choose you. This is a very bad idea, as everybody does this. Everybody goes onto Google and searches CV template. Now, if you as an employer get 10 CVs that look exactly the same, there is no comparison. None of them stand out. And it's very easy for principals to see a generic CV because they've done appointments for more than 10, 15 years. So they know all the generic CV templates, and believe me, they will not be impressed if you give them that. So make the CV personal to each school or institution that you give it to. Okay. Put yourself in the shoes of the principal. Now this is exactly what I just told you. Don't give a generic CV. Just think to yourself, you get all this CVs, it's a whole pile of CVs, and 10 of them look exactly the same, and there's one that looks different. That one is going to get your attention. That one is the CV that you'll remember. Now you might ask, but how do I do this? If I can't use a generic template, what am I going to use? Just calm down, we'll get to that. Okay, so make your CV unique. Make it something different. Be creative. You are all teachers. You are all creative beings, creative souls, because teachers are creative. Think of another way to put your CV together that is not just in a plain structured format. Okay, you want to draw attention to your CV. Okay, so firstly, in your CV, less is more. Okay, now I know you guys have all heard this little saying, less is more, and then you think, but how can I explain everything that I've done? I'm so amazing. How can I put all my amazing achievements into an A4 page? Remember guys, one A4 page has a lot of dimensions. Let's take this board for example, if this was an A4 page. So there are sides to it. It can be horizontal or it can be vertical. There are corners, there's a middle, there's sides. Remember, you don't have to do a CV on Word. No, your CV can be a picture. And for me, the easiest way is to create these pictures where you can put text everywhere on the page is in PowerPoint. Now you all have used PowerPoint for quite a while, I'm pretty sure. So use PowerPoint because PowerPoint allows you to put text boxes wherever you want on the page. So that allows you to have a bigger platform to put your CV things in. And all of you have YouTube channels now. Now we said everything that you'll do this year is gonna have meaning. Okay, we don't force you to create these YouTube channels to create work for yourself and us. Believe you me, it makes more work for us marking those YouTube videos than it does for you uploading them. Okay, so we do this to help you guys. So you have a YouTube channel. Make a link so that they can click on it and there is your YouTube video. So you can have an interactive CV. You can say that you have taught in these various schools throughout your school experience, and if you click on this link, you'll get a summary of the way in which I taught. So that is something unique in your CV that other students won't have because they haven't had exposure into how to deal with this type of media. So can you guys see that us letting you create all these things benefits you in the long run? Okay, so sum up what you want to say. Remember, your CV is the summary of you and what you have achieved and the experiences that you have. But you still have your interview. Okay, you need to be chosen on your CV. That is exactly right. But if your CV is good enough, if it gives you enough information, then your interview is your platform to explain. Whereas if everything's in your CV and you just regurgitate what it says in your CV in your interview, then the employer is also not going to be very impressed because they've read all of that. So they want extra information in the interview. They want you to explain your stuff in the interview. Because so if they've seen your video, they might have a question. Why do you use this search and strategy? And you'll have a more interactive interview because there will be more to speak about, to talk about. Okay? So that's what I said. Remember, you have the interview to explain. So don't think you must put everything in your CV. No, that is not. You summarize in your CV. You always create questions in your CV that they can ask you in the interview. Okay. So you put little interesting facts in your CV. And that encourages the interviewer to give you more questions. But how did you do this? Why do you incorporate technology? How did you incorporate technology? Why did you incorporate technology? Whatever, all these questions can be in your interview. Okay, so how long must it be? It must be an A4 page. Everything that you've done must be put on an A4 page. Why? So that the principal that's going to employ you sees what you have in one page. Now you can imagine if you were a principal and there's a pile of CVs this high and you get a CV that is 30 pages long. Do you think that principal is going to take the time to read all 30 of those pages? No, he reads the first page. Okay, that's why that page must summarize everything that you've done. The rest of the papers is the proof of your experience within your explanation in that first place. So if you say you have a degree, you must attach your degree into your CV. If you say that you've done teaching experience, you can have a link to the teaching experience that you've done if you have a little video or whatever, or a letter from the university or whatever the case may be. So the rest of the papers is almost like the proof that you've done it. If you have a reference in your paper, a personal reference like your mom or your dad, or a professional reference like one of your lecturers that wrote a motivation as to why you should be employed, that can be attached at the back. That's not part of this page. This page summarizes what you've done. Okay. Then, don't lie on your CV. Okay, guys, this is probably the worst thing that you can do on a CV is lie. Okay, don't oversell yourself because you are going to get caught because in your interview, the principal might then ask you about this amazing achievement or this amazing ability that you have. And if you are not able to answer, then that makes a worse impression than you not have put that in your CV. So say, for example, you are not proficient in Excel, for example, a program. Don't put in your CV that you are proficient in Excel because the principal might then ask you, well, how would you put your marks onto an Excel spreadsheet and how would you calculate the total of marks? And if you can't answer that because you are not proficient in Excel, that makes a very bad impression. So only put the information on your CV that is true. If you are proficient in Word, you can put it there. If you are proficient in PowerPoint, you can put it there. If you are proficient in Excel, you can put it there. But don't put information that's not true. Don't say that you were an SA Olympian athlete, and then you get there and they ask you, well, can you coach our athletes? And then you mess up the school system because you can't really coach that. Okay, so don't try to sell yourself. Rather tell the truth, and you can elaborate on the truth than lie. Okay, do your research on the school that you are in. Every school has a motto. Every school has aim. Every school has a goal, a long-term and a short-term goal. And all this information can be found on the website of every school. Go on there and read up on it. Because these goals and morals are imprinted into the school and probably made by the principal. So if you know these goals, you can structure your CV and your answers in your interview in such a way that you illuminate these goals and these things. Do it to your advantage. If the school's goal is knowledge is power, then you can work your CV around that. Then knowledge is very important for them. Power is important for them. So in your little speech in your interview where you tell them about yourself, you can include this. You can include it in your CV. You can say that I go by the saying of knowledge is power, because knowledge enables you to get power or whatever. Okay, once again, don't lie. If this is not what you're looking for, and this will also guide you into that, if you will fit into the school or not. Because you don't want to apply to a school and not really want to be there because you don't agree with their aims and values and goals. You can't go to a Christian school whose moral is we live by God's word, and then you are an atheist, because you are going to be very unhappy at that school, because the morals and values are going to be imprinted into you as a teacher for the next 20 years, and you don't want that to happen. You want to be happy in the school that you are at. So research about the school, then you'll know what you're letting yourself into, and this will then impress the principal as well, because he'll know that you went through the effort to actually know what this school stands for. Okay, so I said, add the proof of everything that you say. Don't just mention you are an Olympic athlete. Attach your certificates, motivation, so on, so that it's proof. Because principals, once again, have had so many applications through the year, they will know if you are lying. So if you attach the proof, they know that that is actually true. Okay, then, what must be in my CV? So I've explained all of this. You know that this is what a CV is about, this is what it should say, and so on. But what should actually be in my CV? Okay, just hold on.